They got cooking in there. It seems like it's starting to come down right now. Thank you. here. Oh well.
Yeah, would have been nice.
Would have.
We're gonna have to come back and do it someday.
I got my raincoat, I got my winter coat, now I don't need it either.
Yeah, I don't know. It could change again just as fast as it could. Look at, I mean, blue. It's the sky just went to blue.
It's
crazy.
Too.
Crazy.
Here we go.
Keep going.
Come on, you go higher than that. Come on.
You gotta go higher than that.
There we go.
Ooh,
we can go. beautiful and bubbly. Can you see it? Yeah. Hi, is it nice? Oh, yeah, nice.
Do you think it's safe to walk out here?
I don't know.
The sign warned us of possibly thin crust. So I'd be careful if I was you. Thank you. says, there's an arrow that says Mammoth this way too, though.
Oh, yeah. Maybe I'm wrong, but I remember.
Trying this. Okay. Where's your mom and dad?
Tanner says all's good this
Where?
Afternoon.
It does look like a ice cavern.
It's such classic tourists. Is that an elk without the antlers?
Is that the llama that the sign was talking about?
I don't think it's a llama.
It might be.
I think llamas are taller. some kind of a deer or something like. Right, keep right. Come on, guy. Yes, to the right. Come on, South Dakota.
So the water is absorbing all the water. Here in Emerald Springs, another factor that I use with light refraction to give this spring its spring.
Thank you.
thing, and you're not the last thing out there.
This is what binoculars are good.
Sure.
Yes, look at this.
Oh, those are definitely bones. This must be from...
I think this winter some wolf got a hold of something.
I think it was an elk at one point.
Yeah.
There's the rest of it over there on the other side of this pond. Rip elk.
probably wondering, they're probably deciding which car they're going to charge at. Chewing on grass.
They're thinking, see, we're getting you back for having slaughtered us all.
up? No. Well, oh yeah, you're right. I think this is that part you said to be careful about on the way back. Good eye. Almost there.
That's not us.
Yeah, but that's right across from where we are.
Once upon a time, at the foot of a great mountain, there was a town where the people known as Happy Folk lived. Their very existence a mystery to the rest of the world, obscured as it was by great clouds. Here they played out their peaceful lives, innocent of the litany of excess and violence that was growing in the world below. To live in harmony with the spirit of the mountain called Monkey was enough. Then one day, strange folk arrived in the town. They came in camouflage, hidden behind dark glasses, but no one noticed them. They only saw shadows. You see, without the truth of the eyes, the happy folk were blind.
Hiding out in holes, waiting for the sunset to come. People going home, jump out from behind them and shoot them in the head. Now everybody dancing, the dance of the dead, the dance of the dead, the dance of the dead.
In time, the strange folk found their way into the higher reaches of the mountain, and it was there that they found the caves of unimaginable sincerity and beauty. By chance, they stumbled upon the place where all good souls come to rest. The strange folk, they coveted the jewels in these caves above all things, and soon they began to mine the mountain, its rich seam fueling the chaos of their own world. Meanwhile, down in the town, the happy folks slept restlessly, their dreams invaded by shadowy figures digging away at their souls. Every day, people would wake and stare at the mountain. Why was it bringing darkness into their lives? And as the strange folk mined deeper and deeper into the mountain, holes began to appear, bringing with them a cold and bitter wind that chilled the very soul of the monkey. For the first time, the happy folk felt fearful, for they knew that soon the monkey would stir from its deep sleep. Then there came a sound, distant first, that grew into cacophony so immense that it could be heard far away in space. There were no screams. There was no time. The mountain called Monkey had spoken. There was only fire. And then, nothing.
Oh, a little town in the USA, the time has come to see. There's nothing you believe you want. But where were you when it all came down on me? Did you call me now?
piece of spine over here. Got more backbone right here than the entire Republican Party. I'll say this guy in the middle here looks a little threatening. Maybe when we get back, we should try to research and find out if there's any signs like when buffaloes are about to attack or charge at us, so we can look for it next time and run away. How much longer we got? Doesn't stay. We're here, up there.
Oh, wait a minute.
Must be itchy.
Yeah.
Oh yeah, maybe. All right, to the right. Do you think they're fighting or trying to have sex? Maybe. Into a hole. All these little holes are their homes. Say what? Oh yeah. So I think it's just on this road, you know? Or maybe it's there. Maybe let's go this way, I guess, like you said. Yeah, they got the thing to hang your bags from. Bad spot to camp at. Oh shit. We're going where we're going. I wonder if like a wolf chased them away or something. Because they seem to move, or they seem to have moved pretty quickly. Not just like leisurely moving to a new spot. What'd you say?
I guess this is what it kind of would have looked like when Lewis and Clark came out here and saw what the fuck.
I bet there was like 10 times the amount of them. I think these bison, they have a little cub with them or something, or calf. So we really should avoid them. They'll probably be protective of it, you know? They're like staring us down. I think we should go down here this way. Are you just gonna go on the trail? Yeah, but I'd rather sprain an ankle than get trampled by a bison. I think there's a shitload more. I mean, there's a whole herd right there. I don't know if there's a way to the right. What an adventure, huh? Hey, I guess there's a teenage bison right there. That guy doesn't look too old. Looks like we'll have company. Thank you. Whew. That was exciting. Thank you.
What are all these people doing?
Right. Mm-hmm. That's the bison rubbing against them.
There you go.
Thank you. Well, that was a lucky shot.
Yeah. What decided that flock to just suddenly up and go join their brethren?
Look behind you. He's spying on us. I think these are those flies you saw on the side of the road yesterday. Yeah, those flies are bigger. Woo! Dang, it's deep over there.
You're all in.
Be careful. Thank you. Careful walking my tracks right here. There's this an underground stream flowing there and you might break through. I just did. I mean, I kind of see a trail down here. Say what? Move? You want me to get out of the way?
Bears going on here. You think?
I do think.
I think that's a bear.
Sure. Even over here too. Thank you. forest buffalo. Big, but not as big as us. That's right, run away. Be afraid.
I wonder if buffalo's presence means bears are less likely or not.
Part of me hopes it's less likely so I don't get attacked. But part of me hopes it's more likely so I see one. This bison was a bear for a second.
Yeah. Is this bear stand? Or buffalo stand?
I think that's buffalo. I think some stuff we saw back there might have been some bear shit. To do.
How many people are going to do a 20-mile hike?
Me?
Another 10 miles.
Really? Made it. Not many people get to see this lake, you know.
It's true.
Kinda, yep. The trick
is, can you make it back?
Oh yeah, easy peasy. Loon?
Loons,
L-O-O-N-S. Is that a type of bird or something?
Yeah.
I'm glad we came all the way. Definitely don't want to come in contact with whatever did that. It's kind of weird. I don't remember that bone being here on the way out. Wonder if the bear was just crossed his trail and dropped it while we were at the lake. One time, I guess it was go around. Oh no, there's a bison laying down over there. Yes.
Did you move for us?
Is it with bison constantly blocking their way back?
How are we gonna get home?
Exactly. Yeah, careful now. And we're supposed to keep within 25 yards of these things. What I should be doing is taking my shoes off.
You should be filming me.
I am filming you and me. You doing it the right way, me doing it the wrong way.
You muddied up my water.
You're gonna muddy it up yourself anyway. Just beat you to the punch. Does. Doesn't really even feel that cold.
Because it's fed by so many hot springs. Maybe.
Maybe.
Maybe that is. I mean, this is not like snow melt, freezing cold mountain streams that I've been in.
I mean, to be honest, it felt pretty cold the first time I walked into it. Might just be that we're used to it now. Dad! Been here, there's a shitload of mud. Careful. When you come over here, walk this way. Stay where the white stuff is. Yep, well, join the club. This way. Want to cross over here, maybe. Maybe. You have to jump. I think right here you'd be good. Maybe here is good. How warm would you say that water is? No, it's gotta be warmer than that.
Oh, I'm gonna say it's almost 90 degrees.
I'd say it's over 100. I'm gonna say that's like almost hot tub water right there. Yeah, true.
Get caught in a snowstorm or something?
Thank you. Thank God that's over.
Oh my God.
Holy shit. It was quite a day.
Alright, we're gonna do one more with the HDR, kids.
The vaccine was made out of it.
Alright, here we go.
Yeah, all that stuff. And so we know all those things.
Alright. Good enough.
If he died, he wants to go. So he got to kind of watch all of his students get more things than he is. But he was the one to start it.
So would you want to hike down right, and like just go ahead and walk around it again now when the crowds aren't as big?
Oh yeah.
See what you think,
Miguel? Yeah. Well, so if it erupts.
It is.
I mean, when it erupts.
Do it.
rock because I just chewed
it. Why?
This will be your photo of the day. Looks like there's some sort of...
We got bubbling springs, we got grass, we got some...
I don't know what's causing these bubbles in here. I dare you to touch this water to see how hot it is.
I am gonna touch it.
Hello.
or picking shoes.